अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द लास्ट कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ सिरोसिस और असाइटिस, दैट इज हेपेटोरिनल सिंड्रोम। सो इट इज़ अ प्रोग्रेसिव डेट्रियोरेशन इन द रीनल फंक्शन इन द पेशेंट्स ऑफ सिरोसिस। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी। इन द सिरोसिस पेशेंट्स देयर इज अ हाइपोपरफ्यूजन टू द किडनीज, दैट इज रिड्यूस्ड सप्लाई ऑफ ब्लड टू द किडनीज। एज अ रिजल्ट देयर इज एक्टिवेशन ऑफ रेनिन एंजियोटेंसिन एल्डोस्टेरोन एक्सिस, which causes increased level of aldosterone and angiotensin too. In this, aldosterone increases the sodium levels as well as water retention in the body, and angiotensin too causes vasoconstriction. Due to the further vasoconstriction, it further deteriorates the renal function by decreasing blood supply to the kidney. It has been classified into hepatorenal syndrome 1 and hepatorenal syndrome 2. In the hepatorenal syndrome 1, the patient has progressive deterioration in the urine output, that is oliguria and non-protein urea. There is no protein in the urine, but the serum creatinine levels are greater than 2.5 mg per deciliter and urinary sodium levels are below 10 millimoles per liter, and urine to plasma osmolality ratio is 1.5, greater than 1.5. But remember, the important thing here is that the renal morphology is preserved. There is no defect in the renal morphology, only the functional impairment in this case. Right? The patients of the hepatorenal syndrome has poor prognosis, and in the management, there is a plasma, there is albumin infusion along with terlipressin. This is a vasopressin analog, as we have discussed in the portal hypertension. The terlipressin is a vasopressin analog. If the terlipressin is not available, then octreotide or modidrine can be used in place of terlipressin. And then hemodialysis, it usually should not be performed because it does not improve the survival rate in hepatorenal syndrome. Usually treat the underlying cause can improve the hepatorenal syndrome. So the liver transplant and along with the TIPS, that is transjugular intrahepatic portosystemic stent shunt, in which the stent is placed between the portal vein and hepatic vein and improves the portal hypertension and decreases the ascites. As a result, there is improvement in the renal function as well. So treat the underlying cause can improve the hepatorenal syndrome. In the hepatorenal syndrome type 2, there is moderately increase in the serum creatinine and it has good prognosis as compared to hepatorenal syndrome type 1. So this was a very little topic. This was whole about hepatorenal syndrome. So we have completed the cirrhosis complications. We will discuss another lecture on the liver in the next video. Thank you so much for watching this video.